Hi and welcome to Asian Photography's YouTube channel. My name is Bhavya Desai and today is all about awesome twosomes. So meet the awesomes and together they combine to make a wonderful twosome. The reason I call these awesome twosomes is because both the Nikon as well as the Canon lens provide you with a versatile and variety of genres and capabilities to shoot from. So today we're going to compare these two lenses against each other to find out which one is better than the other. So let's get started. So before we start testing both of these lenses, there are some key things that we need to keep in mind. Firstly, one thing is that neither of these lenses are compatible with the DSLRs that either of the manufacturers make, which means that they are only powering the mirrorless systems of both Canon as well as Nikon. But in this category, in the mirrorless systems of both the manufacturers, these are the only two lenses which come in the wide zoom sort of a category, which means it makes them very important and hugely versatile. So the next question is then, who are these lenses targeted towards? So these lenses are basically targeted towards everyone who is looking to shoot candid, wedding, portraits, even sports for that matter. And this is precisely the reason why I call them really versatile in nature. But there's not just a difference in the physical size and nature of these two lenses. For example, the Canon lens is the world's first F2 lens in this category. And also in terms of price, there is a huge amount of difference between the two. For example, the Nikon lens comes in at about 1.9 lakhs inclusive of all taxes, whereas the Canon is somewhere approximately between 2.4 lakhs. Also, the unique diameter of both of these lenses makes for a UV filter if you want to buy really expensive. One look at both the lenses and you can understand the difference in the thought processes of both the manufacturers. For example, Nikon has gone for a more standard and conventional look which focuses more on functionality. On the other hand, Canon's lens is a lot bigger, massive and chunkier. But between the two, the Canon seems a lot more in terms of premium and quality build. While both the outer shells of both of these lenses are actually plastic body, like if you can hear this on the mic, but in terms of weather sealing, to me seems that Canon might be slightly better weather sealed than the Nikon. Naturally, the Canon lens is a lot bigger and bulkier as compared to Nikon, which means that when using both of the lenses, you're obviously going to get a little bit more tired with the Canon lens. Now, when we spoke to Canon, Canon says that the lens has increased in the size. It's because of the increase in the number of elements as well as the widest aperture in this category. Now, both of these lenses don't feature image stabilization in them, which also reiterates the fact that these are targeted towards users who basically are not going to shoot videos with these lenses. Whereas Nikon's body is a lot more functional. It shows the rangefinder distance as well as some other information on this lens display, plus a button which changes those display and feature functions, as well as a customizable functional button, including the regular autofocus and manual focus buttons as well. While the display distance on the lens is useful when shooting from the hip, but watch out for the drop in battery use. In terms of handling, both the lenses function very smoothly, especially when popping out as well as in. All the rings function very smoothly yet firmly in order to avoid accidental touch. But the Canon lens actually makes this beautiful clicky sound when you turn it, which is quite awesome. When it came to performance, we checked the chromatic aberration, and in terms of chromatic aberration, both the lenses showed very minimal aberration, with Canon coming in at 0.59 pixels and Nikon being the lesser of the two at 0.29 pixels. When it comes to distortion, the mirrorless systems have always been more prone to them than the conventional DSLRs. Now, in this case as well, Canon showed more perspective as well as barrel distortion than the Nikon. This was very slight, with the subject's face appearing slightly broader at the max focal length in both cases. In terms of color reproduction and accuracy, the colors from the Nikon seem slightly more saturated as opposed to the real scene. Of course, this also depends a lot on the body than the lenses, but in such cases, it's more on the preference of the user and what they like. The overall bokehs were beautiful from both the lenses. It is as if they were really built to deliver great bokehs. They were well rounded and smooth under both daylight as well as low light conditions. But with a wider aperture, Canon had an edge against the Nikon in this department. The results look much more smoother in the images that we shot using the Canon lens. A big advantage of having wider aperture is better low light performance. The low light images from both the lenses were great, and under most conditions, you can easily use these images. But again, Canon seemed to have an advantage here as well because of its wider aperture. Even on zooming in on the images were very sharp and super detailed. In terms of focusing speed as well, both the lenses focused really fast and their ability to track subjects were also great. There was hardly any visible difference in terms of performance in this department. The overall image quality from both the lenses were great. The images showed good colors and detail. In terms of sharpness, both could have performed better with the corners of the images appearing softer in both cases. But even on zooming in close to 100%, there wasn't much loss of details as displayed in the images we shot. Now, this also means that both the lenses are of high quality and deliver great overall image quality in terms of... When it comes to lenses like these, there are always fine margins between choosing the right one. Both of these are quality products and have a lot of things going for them. For example, the Nikon is a lot more affordable, handy, functional, and overall a consistent performer. On the other hand, Canon is a lot bigger, bulkier, and heavier, but all of these things go away when it makes up ground when it comes to its performance. So if you have that extra budget and don't mind shelling that out, then the Canon is the right lens for you. So if you like this video, then make sure that you like, share, and subscribe to our channel. Also, follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, everywhere. Aur hamari sab videos ko like kar dijiye. And until next time, happy viewing.